Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we want to discuss about aggregate transformation and what are the difference between SQL aggregate and SSIS aggregate. So let's start with aggregate transformation. So what is aggregate transformation? So it is used to perform aggregate operations on groups in a dataset. Like we have a dataset and it contains many columns and we want to do aggregate by any specific column, then we can use aggregate transformation to do the same thing. The aggregate functions available are count, sum, average. So these are the functions available in SQL Server as well as in SSIS. Aggregate transformation has one input and one or more than one output. So let's move to our case study. So this is our case study. As we can see, we have input table and it contains the information of phone number. We have ID, phone type and phone number. In ID, ID 1, 2, 3. In phone type, business phone number, cell phone number, home phone number. So we have three type of phone numbers. And we want to do the aggregation on ID and then phone type. So first of all, we want to do the aggregation on phone type, second with the ID. Let's move to SQL Server Management Studio. Here we can see we have the same metadata with this phone aggregate table and we want to do the aggregate by using aggregate transformation. So as we can see, first of all, we want to do aggregation with the phone type, so we can execute our first query. Then we can see business phone has three count, cell phone again has three count and home phone has four. Second, we want to do the aggregation with ID. Then we can execute our second query. Here we can see ID 1 contain 2, ID 2 contain 3 and ID 3 contain 5. So we want to do this aggregation by SSIS. So let's move to SSDT. Then we need to create one more package. Right click on this SSIS package, create a new package. Then we need to rename this package with aggregate. Here we need to drag and drop our data flow task. So we can drag and drop. Then we need to double click on this data flow task. It will directly move to data flow panel. Inside data flow panel, we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. So our source is OLEDB source. So go to on other sources. Then we can drag and drop our OLEDB source. Now we need to configure our OLEDB source. So double click on this OLEDB source. OLEDB source editor window will be open. Now we need to configure our connection manager. So click on new. Here we have already made the connection. So delete this connection and create a new connection. Click on new. Here we need to select our server name. So this is our server name. I am going to use Windows authentication. So there is no need to enter user ID and password. Here we need to select our database name. So database is SSIS test. Now we can check our connection. Connection succeed. Now click on OK. So we have done with connection manager. Now we need to select the table. So as we can see, we have already typed the query. So we can copy this query. We need to change data access mode with SQL command. Here we need to paste the query. Now go to on columns. We want all the columns. So click on OK. So we have done our source. Now we need to configure our transformation. So our transformation is aggregate transformation. Inside this common, we need to drag and drop aggregate transformation and connect with source. Now we need to double click on this aggregate. Here we have the columns. So first of all, we want to do the aggregation with phone type. We need to select the phone type and select phone number. So here we can see we have input columns, output alias, then operation. So we want to do the aggregation with phone type. So our first operation is okay. In our second operation, we want count. So we can change with count. Now click on OK. So we have done our aggregation with phone type. Now we need to set up our destination. So we don't want to load data any destination. We want to just check our data. So we need to drag and drop multicast. Go to on aggregate, connect with multicast. Here we need to enable our data viewer. So enable data viewer. Now I am going to execute this package. So as we can see, phone type B, C and H, 3, 3 and 4. Now move to SQL Server Management Studio and execute our first query. So once we execute our first query, then we can see we are getting the same metadata as we are expected. Now we can stop our package. So here we can see it doesn't support any error output. So here we can check, we don't have any error output. So aggregate transformation doesn't support error output. Next is, so aggregate transformation has one output, and in advanced mode we can configure more than one output. Each will contain different aggregation. So first we have done with phone type. Second, we want to do the aggregation with ID. So double click on this aggregate. So here we can see we have this advance. So click on this advance. As we can see, we have only one aggregate. Here we can configure our second aggregate. So we can click with aggregate 2, and this is for ID. So here we need to configure our second. So this time we want to do the aggregate with ID, and we want to count with phone number. So here we can change this phone number. Click on OK. Now we need to drag and drop one more multicast, and here we can see we have one more output. So we can select. So this is for ID and this is for phone type. So we need to enable data viewer for ID as well. Then we need to execute our package. So as we can see, this is for ID and this is for phone type. So we are getting the multiple aggregate at a single time. So this is the difference between SQL Server and SSIS. In SSIS, we can do multiple aggregate at a single time, but in SQL Server, we cannot do the multiple aggregate at a single time. We can also use aggregate to load unique data by applying group by to all columns. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.